वेलकम टू एनएमई आईसीटी साक्षर ई कंटेंट प्रोजेक्ट अंडर मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ एचआरडी गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। दिस प्रोजेक्ट इज ऑफ मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट। द प्रोजेक्ट इज अंडर एनएमई आईसीटी, दैट इज नेशनल मिशन ऑन एजुकेशन थ्रू इंफॉर्मेशन एंड कम्युनिकेशन टेक्नोलॉजी। अंडर दिस मिशन अ प्रॉपर बैलेंस बिटवीन कंटेंट जनरेशन, research in critical areas relating to imparting of education and connectivity for integrating our knowledge with the advancement in other countries is to be attempted. In order to bolster our knowledge resources to obtain and maintaining the competitive edge in the world, we require a system of identification and nurturing of talent and lifelong learning. Knowledge modules based on personalized needs of the learner would need to be delivered to him or her at the right time with the right content interactively to take care of his or her aspirations. With these objectives in mind, these videos are created for the portal section. We will learn basic marketing over here.
Hi, I am LL means learner. I am learner of marketing management. I learn marketing in master's class. The desire for learning marketing comes out of interest. This is very interesting topic. Marketing management is seen everywhere in the society. You see up or down, you see here and there, you can see brand names and logos and advertisements and people working in marketing area. I am very much interested in learning marketing. Let us learn marketing from Dr. J. Badayani. He is going to teach marketing management under Sakshat e-Content Development Project under National Mission on Education through Information and Communication Technology, that means N-M-E-I-C-T. Let us start learning.
Good morning to all. Today, we are going to learn channel selection and management.
Hello and welcome to Sakshat e-Content on Marketing Management. Today, we are going to understand channel selection and management. Marketing channel can be defined as a set of interdependent organizations involved in the process of making a product or service available for use or consumption, as well as providing a payment mechanism for the provider. The channel of distribution is therefore all those organizations through which a product must pass between its point of production and consumption. It can be said as a point of production, a point of consumption, and the passing stages. The organizations, maybe wholesalers and maybe retailers and maybe marketers and jobbers and brokers and agents, etc. Those organizations through which the product passes from the point of production to the point of consumption, and that is what is known as, you can say, marketing channel. Over here, sales people are not considered as channel because they are not independent and interdependent organizations. Well, if we look to characteristics of marketing channel, we can say that channel consists of institutions out of which some are under the control of producer and some outside the producer's control. It cannot be a distinctive line. Some kind of control can be exerted, some kind of control cannot be exerted. That way, even in between, 100% control and 100% out of control is possible. Channel management process is continuous and requires constant monitoring and reappraisal. Channels should have certain distribution objectives guiding their activities. Well, this is again another characteristic. If you look to flows in marketing channel, we can say that channel mechanism itself is the concept of flow. From the perspective of channel management, there are five important flows in channel management. Number one is product flow. Number two is negotiation flow. Number three is ownership flow. Number four is information flow. And number five is promotion flow. The product flow refers to the movement of the physical product from the manufacturer through all the parties who take physical possession of the product until it reaches to the ultimate consumer. The negotiation flow encompasses the institutions that are associated with the actual exchange processes. The ownership flow shows the movement of the title through the channel. Information flow identifies the individuals who participate in the flow of information either up or down the channel. The promotion flow refers to the flow of persuasive communication in the form of advertising, personal selling, sales promotion, and public relations. Now, let us look to selecting channel member. The most crucial task for the companies is to select their channel member cautiously. While selecting channel members, organizations should evaluate the number of years of experience of channel members, different product lines they carry, growth rate carried, and the profit-making abilities, cooperativeness and competitiveness, financial strength, service and market reputation, etc. Locations, future growth potential and type of clientele are major factors that companies should evaluate if companies want exclusive distribution of the product. There are several factors affecting this channel selection. They are, number one, organizational objectives. If company objective is mass appeal and rapid market penetration, and it's appropriate to select channel members via distributors and retailers. Type of product is the next factor. Generally, perishable products have short distribution channel, and FMCG, fast moving consumer goods products, should have a wide variety and intensive distribution channels. Well, nature and extent of market. Distribution to consumer market and industrial market would require different channel structures. Buying habits of customers. Understanding customers' buying needs and habits even are important over here. Channel availability. Sometimes channels may not be available or accessible, then the availability of channel member become crucial. Motivating channel member is the next point which we are looking over here. As independent institution, channel members are not under the direct control of the firms they represent. As a result, they do not automatically cooperate and comply with manufacturer requests. Thus, manufacturers need to take administrative actions to secure channel intermediaries' cooperation as well as to maintain and improve channel effectiveness. So, motivating channel members plays a strategic role. The company should provide training programs, market research programs, and other capacity building programs to improve intermediaries' performance. The company must constantly communicate its view that the intermediaries are partners in a joint effort to satisfy end users of the product. Manufacturers can use channel power to elicit cooperation from the channel members. Channel power can be defined as the ability to alter channel members' behavior so that they take actions they would not have taken otherwise. Well, there are several types of power that manufacturers can use to elicit cooperation from channel members. If we look to the types, we can say that number one, coercive power. A manufacturer can threaten to withdraw the resource or terminate a relationship if intermediaries fail to cooperate. Next is reward power. The manufacturer offers intermediaries an extra benefit for performing specific acts or functions. Reward power typically produces better results than coercive power. The third is legitimate power. The manufacturer requests a behavior that is warranted under the contract. As long as the intermediaries view the manufacturer as a legitimate leader, legitimate power works. Then, expert power. The manufacturer has a special knowledge that the intermediaries value. Once the expertise is passed on to the intermediaries, however, this power weakens. The manufacturer must continue to develop new expertise so that the intermediaries will want to continue cooperating. Well, that is what is expert power. Referent power is the next one. The manufacturer is so highly respected that intermediaries are proud to be associated with it. Companies such as Ferrari, Audi, Apple have high referent powers. Well, coercive and reward power out of these powers are objectively observable. Legitimate, expert and referent powers are most subjective and dependent on the ability and willingness of parties to recognize them. Definitely. Assessing marketing channel member performance is the next topic which we are looking currently. Producers must periodically evaluate intermediaries' performance against such standards as sales quota attainment, average inventory levels, customer delivery time, treatment of damaged and lost goods, and cooperation in promotional and training programs. A producer will occasionally discover that it is paying too much to particular intermediaries for what they are actually doing. Thus, by assessing the performance of channel members, manufacturers can discern how successful they have been in implementing channel strategies as well as achieving their distribution objectives. So, this was about channel selection and management. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much for the class and watching. I have learned a lot. Did you? Have a good day from the learner.